actually, it's not for setbacks.
Yeah.
Right. Is everybody on their best behaviour?
Can you move a little bit? What is this?
We're going to share a story today. The story is called The Library Bus. Have you read it before?
Have you?
So you know a lot better than I do. So when I go wrong, you can come and help me. Right, well, I shall start before I shall pass it on to the teacher. Arrange the books, clean up, be nice to other girls. Parry repeats under her breath. You'll be great, Mama says. Give Parry a hug. Today's Parry's first day as Mama's library helper. But this is no ordinary library. This is one on wheels. And it's the only library bus in the whole of Kabul. Instead of seats, it has so many books that Parry can hardly count them all. The streets are dark when Parry and Mama leave home. Their first stop is a small village tucked in a valley between two grey mountains. A fiery sun rises over the passing fields. A group of girls stand under a giant oak tree, waiting patiently. One little girl waves her shuttle. Over here, she shouts.
Parry opens the back door, and everyone climbs inside. The girls return the books they borrowed last week and search through the shelves for new books to read. Salam, my girls. Let's make a circle now, Mama says in a calm voice. Everyone pays attention. We are going to practice Singlish. First, they sing the alphabet song, and then they count from 1 to 10. When the lesson ends, a girl in a yellow dress skips over to Parry. Are you new here? She asks. What's your name? Do you live here on the bus? Can you print the ABCs?
I can print them all the way to Z. She talks very fast.
I can print them too, Parry says quickly. But Parry can't even read or write in Farsi yet. Mama starts the bus. Vroom. And they're off to a refugee camp beyond the mountains. The old city spreads out in front of them, like the colorful embroidered scarves in the Grand Bazaar. Tiny houses, dusty roads, one hill after another, and then a ring of rugged mountains. Parry fidgets with her zipper. When did you learn the ACDs, Mama? She asks. Oh, you mean ABC. That's the English alphabet. Just like Alef, Be, Tef in Farsi. Mama takes a deep breath. Grandpa taught me a long time ago, when I was a young girl, girls were not allowed to go to school to learn to read or write. I hid in the basement to study. Parry wonders if Mama was ever afraid in Grandpa's basement. It's always been quite dark down there. Parry, when you go to school next year, I want you to study hard. Never stop learning. Then you will be free. Tell me now, she adds with a wink. How does learning make you feel? Free, Parry screams, raising her arms in the air. It's midday now when they arrive at the camp, and Parry sees rows and rows of tents. There is dust everywhere, and the kids have patches on their clothes. Mama announces, those who need notebooks and pencils go to Parry, and those exchanging books come to me. Parry is surrounded by a crowd of girls asking for school supplies. I need a pencil, a curly-haired girl shouts. Another
another girl squeezes her way to the front of the line. "Give me another notebook," she says, jumping up and down with excitement. Soon, everyone is ready for a lesson. A, B, C, D, repeat after me. One more time. Mama makes the sound like a beautiful song. A, B, C, Pari sings to herself very softly. As they leave the camp, Pari reads the large letters written on the tents. W, P, F, and the next one is U, N, H, C, R. "Good job, Pari," Mummy cries. "You've got them all right." Pari beams with pride.
Back at home, Pari helps Mama make dinner. A bowl of hearty chunks of potato and carrot. At the table, she asks, "Next year, will you teach me to read?" Mama says, "You will go to a real school in the city." "Why can't those girls go to a real school too?" Pari asks. "There are no schools for girls in the village or the camp. They only have a library bus once a week, but I will help them the same way that your grandpa helped me." At bedtime, Mama kisses Pari's forehead. "You did well today." Pari smiles and gives Mama a snug hug. She thinks about the girls in the village and the girls in the camp. She thinks about the library bus, the new places they will go, and the new girls they will meet tomorrow. End of the story.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you so much for reading to our class. We really appreciate it. Can we say goodbye?
Goodbye, everybody.
Keep reading.
You will.
Nathaniel, go ahead, my love.
Your Royal Highness. What an honor to be with you today.
Thank you. got to get it in at least one district. No, no, I've met him.
Oh, you have?
No, I was in the market. They were in the market.
Oh,
I just followed.
The stills guys from there, and I was like, it's Camilla coming down the hall, and I'm like, oh fuck, I think I'm in the wrong place.
We are going to do a group shot with them.
When I say smile, smile.
You're right.
Is he not going for a break?
I've got Alf, I've got your bag.
This goes outside.
Okay.
Let's do that.
Well, I stepped back. There's no point because you got to do your jobs and we did.
Is the prince coming out this way?
Mind the steps are short.
You did!
Never ask a woman what's in her handbag, do you?
Hello.
Sorry.
I'm right here. I'm in the news, probably. My name is Michael. Please, post this on the news.
That's right. Hello, my friend.
Are you bodyguard?
Not yet. There we go. You too, my friend.
I bought me.
There we go.
I'm back.
Yeah, there we go. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.
Yeah, two more lights out there.
That's true. Everybody knows. So if you want to start there,
Excuse me. I want to ask a question. Are you gonna put that on the news?
It's live right now.
Meant a lot to us, and thank you.